Hi, Norbert here, energy engineer and explaining in video number 34B the details of how to live on 12 volt of a battery, of a car battery, instead of on the high voltage of the public grid. This is the detailed video of Saturday. If you want to see the introductory video of last Wednesday, then you can see in this link. I want to thank you very much for the many views of last Wednesday, of this last video. I feel very honored for that, even if I don't know exactly what has changed since the video before. Why should the number of views have changed 50-fold from one video to another? What a surprise! Maybe because I addressed the problem of access to energy, which in so many countries is still a big problem. Even if I feel that also in richer countries the public infrastructure is still too fragile and also getting worse. However, there's no comparison with so many developing countries where access to energy is really a problem. Access to energy is for many really only a dream, and that is for 760 million people. But for many more people who are connected to the grid, it is a problem that the grid is not reliable, and it is a source for worry every day. There's much hydropower in Ghana, like in Switzerland, where I lived and worked for 10 years. About 70% of the total electric consumption is covered by hydropower. However, power outages in Ghana are very frequent, maybe because the demand is growing much faster than the grid capacity. My friend and colleague in Ghana sent me some pictures which clearly show the problem. You see in these pictures how frequent blackouts force a family to use smoking lamps on expensive and also dangerous kerosene. Also, economic activity is impacted, like here on the marketplace. How important it is for them to have at least the essential services. I strongly believe in the rule of Pareto, which says that with 20% of the effort or the cost, you can obtain 80% of the results. The remaining 80% of effort to arrive at 100% will give you only 20% of the results. Maybe that is the difference between the richer and the poorer countries. As said on Wednesday, people in developing countries feel that the essential Pareto value is obtained with light, fans, pumps, refrigeration and telephone charging, but also with televisions and computers. So why look to this video? This detailed video will indicate shortly why I propose to start with a simple system of only a battery and a grid charger. It will show you the components you will have to find and how to put them together. So for now, after this video, you will be only able to maintain a car battery of 12 volt in a charged state with a charger from the grid. But that's not a small thing, because you will be able to have a reliable power source, even if there are frequent blackouts. This video will start to explain why this is the best solution to start with. I will also explain how you can improve it in time after having this basic version. Finally, I will give you a list of examples of household appliances that run on 12 volt DC direct current that can be easily found on the market so that you can run your household. So let's start the energy transition, starting from the people. Yes, let's build a resilient energy infrastructure in many homes that will guarantee clean and reliable energy for you and for your next generations. If you are with me and with the future of this planet, please hit the subscribe button with notification to participate in 360 degree innovation and keep the energy situation in your house under control, under your control, without depending too much on a fragile infrastructure. This is true for developing countries, but also for the richer countries where the energy infrastructures struggle to keep pace with the changes in society. So let's start with the details. First, I show you why you should start simple and grow your system with time from the base. Our baseline is a situation where we have a grid with many blackouts. You may yourself define what is the meaning of frequent. Now, my opinion is that the normal car battery has two qualities that give you an incredible value. The first quality is that in the time that the grid is live, it can accumulate much energy. This type of 100 ampere hours can accumulate up to 1 kilowatt hour. Even if so much energy will discharge it very deeply. The second quality is that it can give for short times an incredible power. That battery of mine of 100 ampere hours is able to give up to 10 kilowatts for a few seconds that you start the engine of the car. You will not need so much power in your household, but if you have many 12 volt devices in your household, you can have moments of peak demand that would be very expensive to satisfy with an inverter. An inverter is a device that will make from 12 volt of a car battery 230 volts AC alternating current. Therefore, I see our addiction to 230 volt appliances a little bit problematic. And I see the combination of the battery with the 12 volt grid charger and 12 volt household appliances as the basis for a system that can grow with you during time. In Europe, such a system would cost a battery of 100 ampere hours, $150. A charger of 10 ampere, $25. A fuse for 100 ampere, $15. A charge and discharge control for 20 amperes, $20. And then other hardware like cables and mounting, let's say $20. And there you have your system, your basic system, where you should start for $230. And you can find those components on the market yourself or in the description, which I give with this video. This is a large amount of money for families in the developing countries. And I know that for many households, this is equivalent to 1 month of income. But this is really a life changer for the family. And I think this is the 80% of Pareto, the 80% of results, I mean. Now I give you some notes on the basic system. I have this lead battery, which you saw, but I have also this lithium battery of the same voltage and capacity of 100 ampere hours. It is 4 times as expensive, but on the whole battery lifetime, it is 4 times as cheap. I mean, each stored kilowatt hour is $6 instead of $24 for the lead battery. And on the second component, the grid charger. I charge my batteries often with a 10 ampere laboratory power supply. It costs twice as much as the charger above, because it can be used for each type of small and big battery. Charging with the correct procedure of constant current and constant voltage, the two phases. But as an extra, it is so flexible that you can use it at every voltage up to 30 volts. And you read the voltage, you read the current, but also the power. I have also this charger of 13 ampere of Victron Energy, which is good for lead and lithium. It tells you also a lot about the charge values and history via your telephone Bluetooth interface. And then I wanted you to show this fuse. It is essential for safety against a short circuit, which produces incredible high temperatures, even evaporating metal. Don't expose your children to such a hazard. And then this charge and discharge controller is in our basic system only a way to avoid deep discharge of the battery. The battery doesn't like such a condition at all. Now let's talk about the growth of your system. From the basic system, you can grow into diverse directions. On the user side, you can buy the 12 volt household appliances that you need, each at a time. If some appliance is available at 230 volts AC only, and it is also low power, then you can buy a small inverter for that appliance only. It will not cost too much, But for example, note that a standard refrigerator has a very high startup current every time that it is started by the thermostat. That will require an external inverter of certainly 500 watt, and that will cost you $100 or more. And that on a refrigerator that has maybe a cost of only $250 or so. Then I would say, if the cost is not prohibitive, that you buy a modern refrigerator with an internal inverter. That will ask hardly a starting current. So then you can buy an external inverter which is much smaller. But of course the best option is to buy a refrigerator working on 12 volts. They are available. And on the front side we are talking about the energy sources. To the grid charger you can add solar panels, wind generators or even muscle power. Your body can easily produce the electric power of 0.7 square meters of photovoltaic panel. So that's more or less 150 watt at any time you want, even without much effort. With do-it-yourself, an electric generator of 300 watt and an old fitness bike, you can build your own personal electric power plant on muscle power and build muscles, not only for your legs, but also for your arms, while generating energy during the day or during the night. In this scenario, this discharge controller is not only a discharge controller, it's also your charge controller, so that your battery will not be damaged. You can charge and discharge the battery at the same time. This controller is able to multitask. I hope you like this video and show your appreciation for my work as the last video of Wednesday. Please like and share the video, subscribe to the video with a notification. I would really like to be able to make this a full-time job and enlighten you, do-it-yourselfer, how to keep control over energy in your home and make this planet a good place to live for everyone. I wish you a good energy.